The industry accepted lifespan of a landfill is a maximum of 20 years, which the Vieux Fort landfill has outlived. 23,000 tons of refuse are deposited there annually, and the facility serves as the main dumping ground for waste from communities from Soufriere to Micoud.
The Vieux Fort landfill was never really designed as a sanitary landfill like the Diglo landfill. So it lacks a leachate pond, whereas the base of it is lined to prevent percolating into the ground. It wasn't done at a manner to accommodate the volume of waste that is presently there. It was stated that the landfill needed to be closed down some 5 years ago. And well, like this in St. Lucia, things that are temporary becomes permanent, and it has gone on so far.
The age of the site is apparent, as are the attempts to extend its lifespan. The attempts have spawned their own set of challenges.
We have experienced about three fires in the last 5 years, one as recently as March 26 of this year. And one of those fires actually cost us in the region of about $200,000 to manage. Presently, it's a ticking time bomb. And there is a study done by the International Civil Aviation Organization which states that the landfill is a risk to the airport now. Imagine if we allow it to go on longer. The question really and truly is, if not now, then when?
No one wants a garbage disposal site in their backyard. This coupled with the challenges in finding suitable land which poses the least environmental impact is a dilemma which the authority has been wrestling with for the past 2 years. Therefore, in the interim phase of the closure, all waste from the south of the island will have to be transported to the Diglo landfill. This move is not expected to affect households, but there may be additional cost implications for the business community.
Maybe it's time that business houses come together and maybe negotiate prices to see if they could bring it down to something that they could afford. Before, they had direct contact with the haulers, and it was negotiated then, something that they couldn't negotiate now.
The imminent closure of this site forms part of government's efforts to have the island free of landfills by 2030. Some of the other climate-friendly initiatives include bans on styrofoam products, restrictions on the use of plastics, and concessions for initiatives geared towards refuse disposal.
We're looking at alternative technology aimed at managing waste without the use of a landfill. We've been working at this from the start of the year. Actually last year, and we right now we're working out economics, technology, operations, contractual arrangements. There's so many moving parts to all of this that we've been working on all of these things. So we hopefully by the end of August we will start off the community engagements and introduce what we're trying to do.
On average, 60 vehicles drive through here daily, and the operating cost is nearly $1 million annually. For the DBS News World, I am Alex Busquet.